absorption phase, molecule should be in non-ionized and non-polar form. Now the next one. The next important thing is concentration gradient. What do you mean by this? See, when you take a drug, let's say this is stomach. When you take a drug, the drug gets in high concentration in this stomach. Now, all the molecule follows a general process called as down the gradient. Down the gradient means the drugs or molecules will get absorbed from higher concentration to lower concentration. So from the stomach, it will be absorbed into blood circulation. Now, that one, there is a phenomenon called as sink phenomenon. Sink phenomenon means the drug will be moving from stomach to blood circulation, but it will not stay there. Blood circulation, the drug will be moving out. So the drug will be distributed to other tissues. So drug will not stay here. If it is not staying here, again, the drug concentration is reduced. Again, from this, the molecules will get absorbed. So because of this factor, the drug will get absorbed. So whenever we take drug in a particular concentration, because of this concentration gradient, drug will be easily absorbed from the stomach to circulation. So the first feature is non-ionized form. Drug should be in non-polar form in order to get absorbed. Second one is, it should be a kind of concentration gradient. This will be there with all the drugs, because initially we take a drug which has got higher concentration. It will be absorbed through the blood circulation. Now the next one. Now see, one more thing related to non-polar nature. Understand the concept called as, see, this nature is known as lipophilic. Now, phil means like, lipid means lipid-liking molecules. See, this is a kind of, there need to be a certain amount of balance between lipophilicity and hydrophilicity. Now, imagine if you have 100% lipophilic molecules, the absorption will be very good. But where it is getting absorbed? From the stomach, it is getting absorbed to blood circulation. Now, it is getting into blood circulation. What is blood made up of? Plasma and cells. Now, plasma has got 60 to 70% water is there. If you're taking completely non-polar drug, it will not be solubilized in the blood plasma. So there need to be a smooth balance between hydrophilicity and lipophilicity. No doubt, drug should have higher amount of lipophilicity, but it is not that 100% lipophilicity will cause us problem, because the drugs are getting absorbed into blood circulation. Blood has got aqueous nature. So there need to be a smooth balance need to be maintained there. Now, after that, we have seen about concentration gradient. Now, the third one is absorbing surface. If there is high surface to get absorbed, drugs can easily get absorbed. Low surface, low absorption will be there. When you compare stomach and intestine, intestine has got large surface area. From the large surface area, drugs can be easily get absorbed, whereas stomach has got smaller surface area. So the surface area will also determine how much amount of drug is getting absorbed. So when you see the primary absorption parameters, the drug needs to be non-polar form. Again, the drug will get absorbed according to concentration gradient from higher concentration to lower concentration, and then the absorbing surface area. Absorbing surface area should be large enough. Next one. Now, let us explore about this one, ionic form. Most of the drugs, whatever the drugs which we have in the market, they are either weakly acidic or weakly basic. Weakly acidic or weakly basic. So weakly acidic, weakly basic, the body pH will affect their ionization. See, in the stomach, we have acidic pH is there. Whereas in the intestine, we have basic pH is there. Now, this pH will determine whether the drug is in ionized form or in unionized form. Take for the example, let's say you have a weak acid is there. Now, weak acid in presence of acidic pH remain as such. Because you have acid there, this is also weak acid. But the weak acid in presence of base, in presence of alkaline media, what happens? The proton will be extracted and it becomes COO minus. Now understand this. Let's say we have taken aspirin, acetyl salicylic acid. Aspirin gets into the stomach. It exists as unionized form. Whereas the aspirin, when it is moved to intestine, where there is a basic pH, it will be in ionized form. So the aspirin will get absorbed from the stomach. Why? Because at the acidic pH, it remains acid. But when it gets into basic pH, it is getting converted into ionic form, it will not get absorbed. So remember this, acidic drugs will get absorbed from acidic pH. What about basic drugs? Let's take an example of a base called ammonia. Now ammonia in presence of acid, what happens? It gets one more proton and gets a charge. So basic drugs in acidic pH will be generating ions. If it is an ionized form, it will not get absorbed. But what happens in basic pH? It remains as such. So they will get absorbed from basic pH environment. Understand this. Acidic drugs will be absorbed from acidic pH compartment. The reason is they remain unionized. The same acidic drug in presence of basic environment will be ionized. So they will not get absorbed from there. Similar concept, basic drugs will be ionized in acidic pH. Take for the example ammonia. In presence of H+, it becomes ammonium ion. Ions will not get absorbed. But when it gets into basic pH, it remains unionized and will get absorbed. So this is a general concept. Acidic drugs will get absorbed from acidic pH. Basic drugs will get absorbed from basic pH. The reason is ionization. When acids get into basic pH, they will get ionized and they will not get absorbed. Now, the next one. How the absorption is taking place? There are three major pathways out there. Now the processes are passive absorption, facilitated absorption, and finally active absorption. Let us understand these three words. Passive means without any help of energy or any carrier, they will just get absorbed as such. Because of their non-polar nature, they can easily cross through that membrane and gets into systemic circulation. Facilitated means with the help of a carrier. There are certain carriers in our entire stomach and intestine. The job, most of the carriers are made up of proteins. The job is they will carry a molecule through their protein pores and deliver it to systemic circulation. Because the movement occurs with the help of a carrier, it is called as facilitated. Now the last one, active transport. The moment you see active means it involves energy. Because it is using ATP energy, it is called as active transport. So these are the three major pathways by which absorption occurs. Now, when you see about this absorption pathway, four factors will determine which their effectiveness. The factors are, first one, how the absorption is occurring, whether it is according to concentration gradient or against the concentration gradient. Technically, it is called as downgradient. Downgradient means drugs will get absorbed from higher concentration to lower concentration. Technically, it is called as down the gradient. It is also known as direction. In which direction and how it is happening? What is the direction? I'll write it as D. Now, direction means whether it is from high concentration to low concentration or not. If it is moving from higher concentration to lower concentration, technically it is known as down the gradient. The opposite one, if it is moving from lower concentration to higher concentration, it is known as against the gradient. Downgradient against the gradient. This is about direction. Now, see, 90% of the drugs will get absorbed by passive diffusion. Diffusion means, you know, in a glass breaker, take some amount of water. Put an ink drop there. What happens? The ink will spread the entire beaker. That process is called as diffusion. So drugs will get absorbed in that diffusion manner. They get into the stomach, they will get diffused because of their non-polar nature. They get just absorbed into, they cross the membranes and get absorbed. So this process, passive diffusion. Now how the passive diffusion direction is? It is down the gradient. Down the gradient means from higher concentration, it moves to lower concentration. When we take a drug, the amount of the drug will be high in the stomach. From there, it will be taken into systemic circulation. So this is called as down the gradient. So first one is direction, in which way it is happening. Now next one, doesn't need any support of carrier. Passive diffusion doesn't need any support of carrier. It just passes through the cell membrane. So carrier support is required? No. Second one, third one, does it require support of energy? Passive, the word itself indicates you don't need energy. So again, energy requirement is not there. Now the last and important one is saturable. Now saturable, let me explain with the concept of facilitated diffusion. Facilitated diffusion occurs with the help of certain transporters, protein transporters. Let's say you have got 50, there are 50 number of transporters are there and you have given 50 molecules. What happens? All the 50 molecules will get bound with this protein transporters and will get delivered into the systemic circulation. What if you take 100 molecules and you have only 50 transporters? 50 molecules will get occupied with the protein transporters, they will get delivered, but 50 will get remained inside the stomach. That means all the proteins are saturated with drug molecules and there are excess drug molecules are remained in the stomach. That is called as saturable. Saturable comes with carrier-mediated transporters. When you have a limited number of carriers and you have high amount of drug concentration, certain amount of the drug will not get transported. Why it is not getting transported? Because the carriers are already occupied. This is not the case with passive diffusion. Passive diffusion do not occur with any carrier. It just diffuses. So saturable means no. So it will not, it is not transported by carriers. So you don't have this saturation concept. The entire drug will get transported. So let me recap this again. See, the major three forms of absorption are passive diffusion, facilitated diffusion, and active absorption. Now, in passive diffusion, it doesn't require any energy. The molecules will get absorbed only because of their non-polaric nature. They can easily cross through the cell membranes, get into systemic circulation. So how, what is the direction? It is known as down the gradient. Understand this, down the gradient means molecules are getting absorbed from high concentration to low concentration, and it is known as down the gradient. Does it need any carrier, passive transport? No. It doesn't require any carrier. Does it require any energy? No, passive means without energy. Is it saturable? No, it is not saturable because carriers are not involved. It just crosses like that. Come back to the next one. Facilitated diffusion. Facilitated means with the help of a particular protein carrier. Facilitated occurs with the help of certain carriers that will carry the drug from the stomach or intestine to systemic circulation. Now this facilitated also occurs down the gradient. So it moves from higher concentration to lower concentration. That means when we take a drug, the concentration of drug will be high in the stomach. From that high concentration, it is absorbed into systemic circulation where you have lower concentration. Does it require carrier? Yes, facilitated means it requires a carrier. A protein carrier is required. Energy, does it require energy? No, it doesn't require energy. It just occurs passively. A carrier is there through which it is just moving. Saturable, because it is carried through a particular protein carriers, when you take high amounts of the drug, all the proteins are occupied. There are certain drug molecules will be present in the stomach. So the facilitated proteins are already saturated, hence these drugs will not get absorbed. So saturable, yes, it will get saturated and some of the drug may not get absorbed into the body when you take higher concentrations. This is about facilitated. So the last one, active transport. Now, active transport utilizes ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Remember, in human bodies, the energy currency is ATP, adenosine triphosphate. It provides energy so that the molecules can go against the concentration. The reason why we say active is the direction is against the gradient. Now understand this one, against the gradient means even though the concentration in the stomach is low or in the blood circulation is high concentration is there, from lower concentration to higher concentration, the drug can move by using energy. See, all the natural phenomena occur down gradient. That means air moves from high pressure to low pressure. That is the reason why we'll get breeze from the seas to land. From the sea, there is high pressure air is there that comes on land and we have a breezy cities with seas. So higher concentration to lower concentration. For these are natural process, doesn't require any energy. But against the gradient, you need energy. Think about a general thing. You pour water from the top, it just goes down because of gravitational pull. If you want water from the down to the top, you need to arrange a motor to pull it up. You need to use some energy. Similarly, from down higher concentration to lower concentration, you don't need to use any energy. But you are, when you are going against the gradient, you need use of energy. Now, active transport occurs with particular prompts which utilizes energy. So, direction is against the gradient. Now, what about carrier? Yes, active transport occurs with the presence of carriers. Now, what about the energy requirement? Yes, it is using ATP, hence it needs energy. Last one, saturable. See, this is also a carrier. So, when you give more higher concentration of drug, all these carriers will get occupied, then it becomes saturated. Hence, it is saturable. Saturable means, yes, it is saturable. See, you don't need to read all the theories, just understand these things. The four major parameters, three modes of absorption. But remember, majority of drugs transfer occur only with this passive diffusion. Passive means without use of any energy. What are the four parameters? What is the direction? The absorption of the drug occurs in down the gradient, from higher concentration to lower concentration. Does it require any carrier? No, it doesn't need any carrier. It just gets absorbed because of its non-polar nature. Does it need energy? It doesn't require energy. That is the reason why it is called as passive. Saturable. It is not using any protein, so it will not get saturated. It just moves down the grid. Next one. Facilitated means with the help of a particular transport proteins. The job is they will transfer the drug molecules across the cell membrane. Direction, again down the grid. Does it require a carrier? Yes, it occurs with the help of. Does it require energy? No, it doesn't require energy. Again, it is a kind of passive facilitated diffusion. Saturable, because it is getting absorbed with the help of proteins, yes, they will get saturated. If you give high concentrations, some of the drugs will get occupied with the transport proteins, remaining things will remain as is. So the carrier molecules will get saturated. Active transport, this occurs, the direction is against the gradient. Because it is going against the gradient, it uses ATP energy. Carrier, yes, it occurs with the help of a protein carrier. Energy, yes, it requires energy. Saturable, yes, it becomes saturated. Now understand these two things. If it is getting saturable, what is the logic behind that? If any drug is moving through facilitator or active transport, you cannot do higher concentrations because complete absorption will not occur. Whereas in case of passive, complete absorption will occur. So these are all the important ways how the drug is getting absorbed into the body. So in absorption, we have seen what are required things and how it is getting absorbed. One more thing is there. While reading about absorption, you need to know two different terms. The terms are